Hi, this is Silver from MSD Ignition. One of the things that we're going to cover is how to test an MSD Ignition box. The most common calls is from a customer is how to test the MSD Ignition box. There's a couple ways that we can do that. One, we can actually test it through the white wire on the MSD box. The other would be through the magnetic input on the MSD box. One of the first things that you want to do is you want to make sure that the ignition switch is off. And you want to make sure that you get the coil wire off the distributor cap to test the first test. Once we remove the coil wire, you want to lay it about 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch from ground. You can use that with a simple screwdriver off your toolbox. And you got to make sure that it stays steady to be able to see the spark. Once you lay it close to ground, there's a couple ways that you can do this. You can use a screwdriver or a spark tester. Spark testers are offered in any hardware store. And once you can get with a spark tester or a screwdriver, you can either hook it up to a good ground and make sure it's secure. Once it's secure, you can actually see the spark at that point. For this application, we're testing a point style distributor. The MSD box is being triggered via the white wire. So once you set your screwdriver close to ground, you're gonna actually see the spark occurring at this point. As I tap it and release from ground, a spark should occur. This test actually concludes that the MSD box and the coil are working properly. As a precaution, make sure when you hook up the coil wire and ignition tester, make sure that there's no fuel around or you don't get it close to the carburetor. The other test that you can do to the MSD box to be able to test it, if you're triggering off a MSD distributor with a magnetic pickup or any stock distributor that has a magnetic pickup, you take the two purple and green wires going into the MSD box, take a simple paper clip and just open the paper clip just enough and you will be shorting both purple and green together. And at the time you're touching releasing, you should be able to see the spark occurring at that gap on the coil wire. Also, one of the things that you can verify that if the MSD box is actually getting a signal, you can see the red LED light on the box. And every time you touch and release and the box receives a signal, you can see that the box blinks. MSD also offers an ignition tester, part number 8998. It's a more sophisticated way to actually test the ignition. On this particular application, you can test from the points input to the mag input on the MSD box. You will also be able to test spark, higher RPM misfires. Also, anything that's associated with the MSD box, you'll be able to test RPM activated switches, your TAC, shift lights. So anything that's actually associated with the box, you'll be able to actually test it and run through the test and bring it up in RPM. Once you hook up the MSD ignition tester, you got your power and your ground to the battery, and you have your spark tester hooked up to the coil wire. And depending how you're triggering the MSD box, like in this application, since it's a points distributor, we're triggering off a white wire. So make sure that the white wire is hooked up to the white wire on the MSD box. Then you can see on your screen the cylinder application. You can switch it from 6-4 cylinder, 6-odd, or 6-8 cylinder application. With 8 cylinder application, which this applies to this vehicle, you can now turn the coarse knob, which is the top knob, and then the fine knob, which is gets you a more precise RPM. Once you start firing, as you can see on the spark plug tester, it starts sparking. And you can go as high as you need to be able to fire it up. Or if you need fine RPM, and that fine RPM is for your RPM activated switches, your tacks, your shift lights, or anything that is hooked up to the MSD box. The ignition box itself offers both a coarse RPM setting, which is your faster RPM, and a fine RPM setting. So if you're meticulous about what RPM your shift light's turning on, you can actually turn the knob and then fine-tune it with the fine-tune RPM.